So we're seeing augmented reality and virtual reality heading towards the mainstream right now.
The audience is ready for this technology, and it's just the tip of the iceberg.
What are you going to build? What kind of world are you going to create?
What we're particularly interested in is how virtual reality and then potentially augmented reality can move just purely from gaming and rich media to actually some really interesting enterprise or workplace use cases.
Where it's going to take the industry is towards natural interactions with the digital world. Then you layer on other interaction points like sensors and voice recognition and image recognition. You start to pull all this together and you've got a natural way of interacting with technology that doesn't require a keyboard or a touchpad.
It's a lot more interesting to interact with an environment when the environment can actually respond to you.
But you should be exploring, what does it mean for your business model to have different types of interaction points with your customers and with your employees?
One item we call out on the radar this time is Google's proposal around the physical web, which is basically a simple beacon-based Bluetooth protocol. And we're very excited about how the confluence of augmented reality, physical world, and physical web can play really nicely together. And in the augmented reality world, things are moving a little bit more slowly, but now the Microsoft's HoloLens, a new headset for augmented reality, is now in early release.
I think the thing that's really compelling about it is actually the fact that it comes from Microsoft, and Microsoft plays heavily in the enterprise space. So I can see them creating partnerships with enterprises and developing applications on this.
There's lots of 3D modeling type technologies and software that you need to get a handle on. And a lot of this is coming out of the gaming world. And Unity is one of the major tools that we're using that supports 3D modeling for virtual reality and augmented reality.
Breaking our old modes of thinking about how we can solve particular problems or even what kinds of problems we can solve, I think that's going to open up the application of both AR and VR.
So if you're not quite ready to invest in a VR headset or even more so an AR headset, then you can download one of the many AR SDKs and start investigating, start assessing, start exploring what you can build on those. And to be honest, once you get into it, it's really exciting.